Hey everyone, James Reeves with TFBTV. Today on TFBTV, we're looking at SIG's newest handgun, the SIG 320X Compact. Over the past couple of decades, SIG has developed somewhat of a reputation for developing, marketing, and selling virtually endless permutations of the exact same design. Does anybody remember the rainbow titanium guns from the 2000s? And while I applaud providing more options rather than fewer, even if we're talking about rainbow-colored guns, there's somewhat of a boy who cried wolf effect anytime a new SIG pistol is introduced. You simply don't know whether or not it's truly going to be exciting. So when SIG told me at SHOT Show 2019 that the new 320X Compact was coming, if you'll notice, I didn't even interview SIG about the new pistol at SHOT this year. Compare that to the handful of interviews at SHOT Show 2018 when SIG dropped the 365 and several other significant expansions of their firearms line. What I'm trying to say is that I thought this was going to be another superfluous addition to the SIG 320 line, which already has more variants than I can count. Those of you who watch TFBTV know that we're not afraid to admit it when we're wrong, and this is one of those times. I was wrong to not care about the 320X Compact. Although I skipped it at SHOT Show 2019, when SIG asked me if I wanted to review one, I said, sure, why not? I already like the 320, so if anything, it might be fun to spin the 320XC. As it happened, the 320X Compact is one of the three or four pistols that has genuinely blown my mind in the past year, and I'm going to tell you why. The SIG P320, generally speaking, is a polymer-framed, striker-fired handgun, which is, of course, all the rage these days. While there are many polymer-framed, striker-fired handguns on the market, SIG has a couple of tricks up its sleeve with the 320. First, the SIG P320 features a serialized internal chassis that allows you to change out the frame of the gun, so you can easily switch from different sizes of frame without having to buy a new pistol, and for a fraction of the price. Second, as many of you knew already, the SIG P320 won the U.S. military's modular handgun system competition, and it is therefore going to be replacing the Beretta M9 as the sidearm of the greatest military on the face of the earth. The 320 has a small but easy to deploy triangular mag release on the grip. It works very well, and in spite of the fact that it has a very small slide release tab similar to the M&P from Smith & Wesson or the Glock, the 320's release seems easier to hit, although I also find myself more likely to accidentally tag it with my natural shooting grip. Takedown is simple and similar to the 226s and the 220s of old. Just lock the slide back, swing that takedown lever 90 degrees, and slide the slide. The barrel and recoil spring easily pop in and out. No need to pull the trigger for takedown. The SIG P320X Compact is a variant of the SIG P320. Looking at the big picture, SIG has taken the P320, but added all of the features that concealed carriers spend hundreds, if not thousands of dollars on when they add to their bone stock carry guns. They configured it in a package that is just about the ideal size for concealed carry, similar to the Glock 19. Like the Glock 19, the 9mm XC holds 15 rounds in the magazine plus one in the chamber. The SIG 320 XC has an overall length of 7 inches and a barrel length of 3.6 inches. The barrel is 0.4 inches shorter than the 4-inch barrel from the Glock 19. So not only is the barrel shorter, but the slide is 0.4 inches shorter. Accordingly, the Glock 19 will have a very slight ballistic performance advantage and a slightly longer sight radius than the 320. And although the 320XC has a smaller footprint than the Glock 19, it weighs about 1.5 ounces more. This is most likely because the SIG 320 is slightly thicker than much of its competition. While it might not bother most people that the 320X Compact is 1.3 inches thick or 1/10 of an inch thicker than the 1.2 inch thick Glock 19, experienced carriers will notice the extra girth and weight, slight though it may be. The 320XC has a better than average stock trigger and excellent balance. It's the right weight and the right size for a compact double stack carry gun. The nitron over stainless construction of the slide means that this gun is almost totally rust proof. The features and the subtle design cues of the 320XC are really what bring this pistol from good to great. There are thoughtful additions that are usually only found in the high-end boutique guns like the Terran Tactical Combat Master, for example. The 320XC comes standard with forward slide serrations and SIG's X-ray night sights. But forward slide serrations and night sights are becoming somewhat standard in this compact carry sector. Lucky for us, the 320X is not nearly through with its bag of tricks just yet. It also comes optics ready out of the box. As you can see here, there's a removable plate on top of the slide that allows you to use an RMR or a reflex optic. While I'm not a huge fan of reflex optics on a carry pistol, many people are, and that number continues to grow by leaps and bounds every day. The 320XC also features a factory straight trigger. Being perfectly honest again, I'm not certain that a straight trigger performs any better than a curved trigger in my experience. But without question, prevailing concealed carry dogma holds that a straight trigger is, for one reason or another, better than the standard curved trigger these days. Regardless of how you feel about straight versus curved triggers, this cue certainly shows that the designers of the 320X Compact had their fingers on the pulse of the very current CCW market. The only commercial scale pistol I've seen with a straight trigger out of the box in recent history has been the Mossberg MC1SC. All of these design features show that SIG truly endeavored to make a gun that was out of the box, configured the way that any concealed carrier would equip this gun in 2019, not in 2009. The 320XC is certainly a la mode with all the options, and to borrow a line from my good friend Billy Mays, may he rest in peace. But wait, there's more. I've saved my favorite features for last. The 320X Compact comes with an extended beaver tail that does a fantastic job of spreading the recoil impulse along the area of your dominant grip hand. And it also features a trigger guard undercut and grip contouring that's more comfortable than a blanket made out of panda bear skins. And while the beaver tail and undercut are comfortable, the grip texturing is perfectly uncomfortable. And I mean that in a good way. It's a very grippy skateboard tape-like texture on the sides, the front, and the back strap. There's some nice beveling on the grip directly under the trigger guard, which makes it very easy and comfortable to obtain an affirmative grip with your dominant hand. And instead of having a straight trigger guard, the underside of the trigger guard has what is referred to as an undercut. Not only does the undercut make your grip more ergonomic, but for those of us who have shot several hundred or thousands of rounds at a training course over hours or days, we'll know that an undercut will help with those pesky blisters and calluses that tend to form with a conventional straight edge trigger guard. So listen, if anyone from SIG's watching this video, you guys owe the engineer that came up with this feature set a six pack of a Beta Strawberry. I'll Venmo you if I have to. That's really the main draw with the 320X Compact. All these features. If you plan on carrying it, there's literally nothing else that you need to do with this gun at all. This is truly the first pistol under $650 that I can say is unmodifiable out of the box, except for maybe the Gen 5 Glock 19 MOS. There's just no need to mess with it, unless you have the urge to be a special little snowflake. I shot this 320X Compact with the guys at the St. Bernard Indoor Shooting Center in New Orleans, Louisiana, and they are all excellent pistol shooters. Each and every one of these guys was wowed by the 320XC, but they all had the same negative observations I did, as far as the very, very few downsides of the gun. This is completely nitpicking, in fact, because this gun is virtually perfect, but the trigger reset is not as enthusiastic as you might find on competing polymer framed guns. We all noticed that the trigger reset was a bit sluggish, and I mean just barely. With trigger reset, you really want a power bottom of a trigger shoe. You want that trigger pushing back hard against your index finger, assisting you to get to the reset point as quickly as possible for lightning fast splits. The 320XC was definitely not as pushy as a stock Glock trigger might have been. I'm a little reluctant to bring up my second complaint because it may have been ammo related, I'm not sure. We were shooting older reloads that may have been a little light in charge, and this could have caused erratic extraction that we experienced when we fired the 320XC. We also had one and only one failure to eject very early on, but it was the general consensus among the guys that this ammo was a little bit anemic and probably caused this stoppage. The 320XC looks good on paper. It's got really great features, but how does it translate into actual real-world performance? Well, extraordinarily. The gun shot extremely well. As far as an out-of-the-box, non-tournament, purely utilitarian pistol, this was one of the best performing handguns that I think I've ever reviewed for TFBTV. Performance was right up there with, say, a Performance Center M&P from Smith & Wesson or an MOS gun from Glock. I was pleasantly surprised with how well it handled and functioned, as was the rest of the group. You had this blend of better than average trigger, better than average sights, great construction, but combined with extraordinary ergonomics and extremely effective recoil mitigation from the grip design that just made this gun perform like a dream. At the time of filming, I don't have any price details on the 320X Compact, and in fact, it just hit the market this week. However, if this gun's going to be priced the same as the 320X carry, its bigger brother, then it seems like it's going to be a steal. The 320X carry is running about $625 to $650 street price, and there are a lot of top performing double stack compacts for several hundred dollars less. However, when you consider that even adding night sights to one of those guns will be a $100 endeavor, not to mention optics ready capability, forward slide serrations, beaver tail, grip contouring, a straight trigger, I would just as soon spring the extra $100 or $200 and get a gun that's fully loaded out of the box. You may not like it, but this just might be what peak performance looks like. Guys, thanks a ton for watching this review. I really enjoyed shooting the 320X Compact, and I think you will too. Thanks a ton to our sponsors, Ventura Munitions, the best ammunition store on the planet. I need, apparently, to get some new ammo from Ventura Munitions because these reloads I was shooting were garbage. And thank you to Blue Alpha Gear, the makers of the best gun belts. Thank you to you guys, speaking of the best on the face of the earth. You guys are the best fans, supporters, subscribers. Go help us out on Patreon. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. I will see you next week.